Hi there, and welcome to another episode here on Theme Isle WordPress tutorials and reviews. My name is Robert, and in this video, I test how fast is OceanWP compared with Astra and Neve. These are some of the most popular WordPress themes out there, optimized for Elementor. Just take a look at the numbers. OceanWP has more than 400,000 installations, as well as Astra. And Neve has 40k active installs, even though it was launched less than a year ago. During the tests on jtmetrics.com, the software analyzed data like PageSpeed, fully loaded time, total page size, and requests. I start testing how fast each theme is bare bones, precisely as it comes after installing it on a new WordPress website. Then I install the Elementor Page Builder plugin and test again how it works in combination with this fantastic tool. We know that plugins can slow down your WordPress website, so this is why I am doing it. Finally, I import one of Elementor's free templates and test again. Content, especially images, have a significant impact on your website loading time, so this is again very important to know. If you want image optimization on autopilot, check out optimoli.com. So, by taking these tests, we find out what's happening before and after we add some content on our WordPress website. Although I can be biased because of Neve, which is our theme, anyone can test these themes or any other WordPress theme using the same tools and strategy and see what's happening. Are you ready? Let's get into it. First of all, I reset everything on this website, which is pretty new. I bought it a couple of weeks ago from SiteGround. If you would like to see how easy it is to start a WordPress website on SiteGround, check out the video in the description box. So, by having this utterly new website, we can see how WordPress performs when there is nothing but the 2019 theme, along with the default hello post and a sample page. To do that, I reset the entire website using the WP Reset plugin, which you can find in the Tools menu after installing it. Type in Reset in this field and then click on Reset. Be careful with this action because it will delete everything you have on your database like posts, pages, images, and so on. You can do it on a new website, but avoid doing it on older WordPress sites with lots of content, unless you have a working backup. Okay, let's see what I have on the front end right now. Exactly what I want. I only have the default theme, and there is no image in the media library. No plugins activated here, and we have just one sample post and two default pages. Let's test the speed of the website as it is right now. I put the links for tools and other resources in the description box so that you can check it out later. The server I use for hosting this website is somewhere in Europe. That is what I saw when setting up the hosting from SiteGround. So I choose London, UK over here, and leave everything else off. Just paste the link of your website over here, and then click on Analyze. Now, I need to wait a couple of seconds while the performance scores are displayed. And then, here we are. The page speed score right now is A, and the fully loaded time is 0.8 seconds, which is normal when the total page size is only 56.1 kilobytes. I am curious how the default theme of WordPress performs versus Astra, Neve, and OceanWP. You can test other themes as well. Do you want me to do it for you? Leave a comment below. Tell me what themes you have in mind. Hit the subscribe button. ring the bell, and you are all set. The only thing I need to do right now is to install and then activate OceanWP. That's it. No plugins and no additional pages. I start testing each theme without content. So, let's check the numbers right now. No big surprise. The OceanWP theme gets good overall results, but the fully loaded time is now 0.8 seconds for a 283 kilobytes page size and 19 requests. Now, I am curious what is happening after I install and activate the Elementor plugin. I have it installed already, and I just need to activate it. Next, I click on Retest above and wait until the test ends. No difference at all for now, but let me do one more thing and test it again. Go back to my dashboard, add a new page, like so, and name it Elementor PageSpeed Test, so I can easily recognize it for the next step. When the editor shows up after I click on Edit with Elementor, I import one of its free templates. Let's choose a popular one. This is just fine, for example. Publish the page as it is right now, or maybe choose the Elementor canvas in Settings over here. Doesn't matter. The only thing that matters, I guess, is to keep the same settings for all. And then click on Publish. To make this page show up as my homepage, I access the settings, then reading, and select the Elementor page speed test as a static page in this dropdown. I am going to click Save Changes below, and then I'll reload the page to see if everything is in its place. Great! Now we can retest again and see the final results. After a couple of seconds, you can see the numbers displayed that speak for themselves. What we know is that we have more content on the homepage and also some images. So, this pulls the page speed down to 91% and the fully loaded time is now higher. Well, I see 1.3 seconds for a total page size of 1.68 megabytes and 52 requests. Let's compare that with the following theme. So, I reset everything again, and when the process ends, I install and activate the Neve WordPress theme. There is nothing but the bare-bones theme on the site right now. So, let's check the numbers for it. We can see that the page speed score is 100%. Fully loaded time is 0.7 seconds. Wow, that's fast because the total page size is just 33 kilobytes and we only have 7 requests. Now, let's activate Elementor and use the same template on the homepage. To do that, create a new page again, import the content and set it as a static page in Settings. After we retest the page on gtmetrics.com, we can see that the fully loaded time is now 1.3 seconds for a 1.59 megabyte page size and 45 requests. Almost the same as OceanWP. I put the numbers side by side at the end of the video, so stay with me. Let's do something smart to avoid resetting the entire site over and over. I move the page to the trash, deactivate Elementor, and install the next theme, which is Astra. I hope that it does not influence any results, as I'm not doing any other changes and not adding more content. So, let's test the final theme in our video. Install and activate Astra. Then test it without content. Here are the numbers. The fully loaded time is 1 second, total page size is 46.5 kilobytes and we have just 9 requests. Cool. I go to the pages trash now and restore the Elementor page. Activate Elementor in plugins and then set the Elementor page as a static page in reading settings one more time. Now I have that page as my homepage, but I can see that is not as it should be. So I edit it with Elementor and set the page layout as Elementor Canvas, over here. Yeah, this is what I want, so I can do the retest again. To put the results side by side, I reactivate each theme one by one. And I use the compare button over here. What you see next is the full tests with theme plus Elementor and the same page that has the same template set as homepage. Because we are using the same link, I use a trick to observe what theme we have the results for. To do that, I edit the page and type in Astra theme over here. Update the changes and click on retest. For Neve, I activate the theme and then I replace this with Neve. Now I click on compare and paste the same URL in the field. When the test reveals its numbers, we can see that the first column is for Astra. Here is Neve. And we can add another URL for OceanWP. Before doing that, I activate OceanWP in themes, and then I replace this text with OceanWP. Here we are. These are the numbers side by side from Astra, Neve and OceanWP. It looks like Neve is the fastest theme in our comparison with or without content. The figures are very close, so if you want a WordPress theme that is well optimized for Elementor and it's fast, Neve, Astra and OceanWP are excellent choices. Also, the best part is that you can get them for free. The only thing you should compare next is what unique features these themes have for you. You can check, for example, the header and footer builder of Neve, which could be a real help if you want to build custom headers and footers when using the free version of Elementor. OceanWP, on the other hand, has many settings for typography and other things you can access in the general options menu. I think the best part of Astra is over here, in colors and background, where you can change the base colors. Each theme has its unique features, so you are the one who decides. Check out each feature carefully and choose the one that fits your needs. If you have questions, feel free to leave a comment below. I'm happy to start a conversation with you. If you want more videos like this, hit the subscribe button and then ring the bell to get notified when we publish our next video. See you there!